Welcome to Up Science, friends. Let's jump into the fourth dimension. I have some amazing information and examples. Before trying to understand the fourth dimension, if we look at the other dimensions, it will make understanding the fourth dimension a bit easier. So now I want you to imagine a point. If we put a lot of these points in a row, we will have a line. Now we have entered a one-dimensional space. If we put a lot of these lines together, we will have a square, and then a two-dimensional space. If we stack a lot of these squares together, we will have a cube, and then a three-dimensional space. In the third dimension, to specify a coordinate, we need to specify where we are on the x, y, and z axes. But in the fourth dimension, we also have a time dimension. Without it, we can't specify the exact position of an object in space. Imagine the surface of the Earth is a two-dimensional space. If we want to determine the geographic location of a ship on this surface, we need the x and y coordinates. But if we want to determine the location of an airplane, we also need the altitude, or the z coordinate. But to determine the exact location of an airplane in space, we also need the time dimension. For example, if we fire a missile and want the airplane to stop, if we don't get the airplane and the missile at the same place at the same time, we can't hit it. Therefore, just knowing the XYZ position is not enough. We also need to know where it is in time. This is what it means to have a fourth spatial dimension, which is beyond the three spatial and one temporal dimensions that we can currently perceive and understand. Can we imagine such a thing now and try to understand it? I just mentioned that each zodiac sign's building block comes from a lower dimension. Therefore, the structure of the fourth dimension is the third dimension. So, let's say we want to get a four-dimensional sphere or cylinder. We need to stack many three-dimensional cubes on top of each other. But it doesn't seem like stacking two-dimensional squares will take us to the third dimension. We don't know how a direction comes into play in the fourth dimension. So, many three-dimensional cubes will have to somehow stack on top of each other to create a four-dimensional hypercube. So, we can infer that the four-dimensional universe is formed by the integration of many three-dimensional universes, just like our own. If we want to see a being from a higher dimension, it can only be seen if it enters the lower dimension. So, even though we live in a three-dimensional universe now, we can't see the fourth dimension, unless it passes through our dream. What you see on the screen right now is not a representation of a four-dimensional cube. It only represents the shadow of a four-dimensional cube falling on our three-dimensional world. In fact, the situation is even more tragic. Right now, you're trying to understand the fourth dimension by looking at the reflection of a four-dimensional cube on a two-dimensional screen. In reality, we can never understand the fourth dimension. Because an organism cannot understand or experience something it has never seen before. It's like trying to imagine a new color. You can't do it by closing your eyes and trying to imagine it, because you've never seen it before. So, what should we do? Should we give up immediately? No, we'll think simpler. If we ever came across a fourth-dimensional object, we would only be able to see the fractions of it that are reflected in our three-dimensional world. I hope you understand what I mean. Imagine an American astronomer telling a story about the cosmos, like he's in a peaceful region in the cosmos. Let's say there's a two-dimensional flat world, and the inhabitants of this world have no idea what the concept of up means. If you were to call out to the circular friend you see here from the third dimension, what would happen? He wouldn't be able to see you because he doesn't have the concept of the third dimension. It's the same for us and the fourth dimension. The same applies to us. If there was a fourth dimensional being, we would only be able to see its three-dimensional projection if it inserted its finger into our world. So, we would see it as a three-dimensional finger. If we were able to enter the fourth dimension, we would be able to see inside the walls, houses and even the internal organs of people, just like our two-dimensional friend who lives in a two-dimensional world. To better understand how this is possible, let's look at examples from two different computer games. Imagine you're currently looking at a two-dimensional world on your screen. This man can see the events happening in the two-dimensional history. Now, let's make the world around him three-dimensional. This is what the real world actually looks like. The two-dimensional shapes the man has seen before are only projections of the actual objects. For example, if I move the red bathtub in the third dimension, the man will see it in a strange way. He will see the large face of the object and even that it is standing in the pool. If I completely remove the sphere from its context, the man will see it disappear in a mysterious way in his own universe. If I move the man to a two-dimensional plane, the shapes he sees will begin to change because I am changing the place where the objects are cut. This situation is very logical for us, but it's mind-boggling for the man. Now, let's go to the next dimension and try to understand the four-dimensional world by looking at it from three dimensions. The objects you are currently seeing are four-dimensional, but we can only see their three-dimensional projections, which is similar to the situation the man was in earlier. The objects are not behaving as one would expect in a three-dimensional world. Actually, the current time is a cut of a four-dimensional hypersphere in the air, but now it has moved to a fourth-dimensional place and has completely exited your field of view. If we move this three-dimensional plane trace along the fourth dimension, objects will change shape, but in reality, we are just looking at different three-dimensional cuts taken from the same objects. We just took the camera out of the two-dimensional plane and looked at what was happening in the third dimension. But this time, we can't do the same thing and look at the fourth dimension because our universe is only three-dimensional. Now let's take a look at the region of the neck of this friend who lives in a three-dimensional world and wants to help the woman behind the wall. How can he do this? If he could move to the fourth dimension, he could easily pass through the wall. Why is this so? Let's look at a little dimension again. For example, this friend who lives in a two-dimensional world, can he go over the wall in front of him and reach the girl? Of course, by moving to a higher dimension, now let's move him to the third dimension and thus he can pass through the right side of the wall and return to his own two-dimensional world. Here it is, that's how the girl doesn't know how he opened the wall because she doesn't know anything about the third dimension, she thinks he appeared next to her suddenly by passing through the wall. The same thing happens in the three-dimensional world. If this friend moves to the fourth dimension, he can overcome the wall in front of him in a way we can't understand and help the woman and save her. So that's the concept of the fourth dimension. Physicists say that there are 3+1, meaning 3 spatial dimensions plus 1 time dimension beyond which have not yet been proven, but sometimes solving physical equations requires more than 3+1. This can be a mathematical requirement, not a physical one. For example, the theory closest to everything, the superstring theory, or concepts like the Enigma, require describing the universe in 10 or even 11 dimensions to work. That's it from me for now, until we meet again in the next video. Goodbye.